Hello everyone, welcome to educators.com. This is Surya Prakash, your Unix trainer. This video is about handling the ordinary files in Unix. In this video, we will learn about how to create a file and how to display the content of a file, and we'll learn how to copy and move files from one location to other, and we'll also discuss about paging the output, that is how to read large files with large amount of data. And next, we will learn how to count the number of lines or words and characters in a file, and we will also learn about how to split a file and how to perform file comparisons. So while working with the system or a Unix system, we tend to edit the files, or we sometimes write some data to the file, or we sometimes need to check the content in a particular file. So all these operations can be performed using a command named cat. So cat is one of the most important implementations that is available in Unix. We can display the contents of a particular file, and we can also create the files, and we can provide data to the files using cat command. So we'll now log on to the terminal and we'll check how to work with cat. So before going on to the terminal, just for usage of a command, you can refer to the screen. So in order to display the contents of a file, we specify cat space file name that would display the contents of a file. So if you want to create a file and if you want to write some data to the file, then cat greater than space file name would do that. So we'll check all these functionalities logging onto the terminal. So we are now on the terminal. So before getting to, we'll check how to display the file. So further before, I would like to know any file is available on my system. So by this I can see that there are few files available here. So before that, I'll just cat a file name named ls file. So this would display the content of a particular file. So this is used to display, so clearing the screen. So cat is very useful when we are working with a small number of files, I mean the file which has a small amount of data. For example, if you are working with a larger amount of data, file is cat is not that feasible to display the content. There are many other options, so which we'll discuss in the coming slides and coming video. So I'd like to just check with us another file name, sortnum. So when you give cat a space a file name, so we'll just display the content of that particular file without changing any content. So we can just display. So now the way to create a file is, so in the same command, if you do cat space and greater than symbol with a file name called cat demo, for example, for now I'm creating a file named cat demo. So there are two input ways. So one is standard input and another is the input redirection. For now, so what is the input redirection? The complete information about redirection can be found in the video named redirections. Please refer for more information that video. So now I'm giving a standard input for my keyboard. So hello viewer, hope you are enjoying our classes. So by giving control D, we can stop the input stream of data, and that is now file will be saved and closed. Now if I want to check the content of that particular file, I again want to display the content. So using cat command, I'm doing that. Cat demo will display the content. So whichever the data we have provided has been stored in that particular file. So now this is one option. So I would like to write more data to that particular file named cat demo. So I'm again using the same command, cat demo. So like, this is about Unix cat command or Unix cat command, and now I've been closed. So if I again read the data from the cat demo, so let's check what data. Oh, what's wrong with this? Yes, exactly. So when we use this command in the same again to cat greater than and cat demo, so this will erase the previous data and write the new incoming string to that particular file. So in order to avoid this data loss, so we can use appending. before that. So we can use cat greater than symbolizes appending. So we are now appending the incoming data to the available file. So this is about Unix. Have been close my file saving it. So by using cat demo, now I can display the content of that particular file. If you see now, I have my previous data and the new data which has been appended to that particular file. And one important thing is that we can also use the append symbol in order to, but when we use this symbol, if there is no file name, the cat demo true, it will create a file and it will write to that particular file for the first time, and from next on time onwards it will append the incoming data to that. So I would like to write, this is my second file, I'm writing it. So now I would like to save these two lines to that particular file. If I see that cat demo, so this is my new file. If I say, so this is my new file, and I've written a new file. Cat also provides a feature where we can combine two or more files. So for example, I would like to combine a cat and a cat demo file. So I'd like to can and cat demo 2. I would like to combine to a form called cat combine. So if I use this, so my content will be stored to a cat combine file. So I'm going to read again, cat combine file. So if I give this, so I can see that the data from cat demo and cat demo 2 is added to into a single file named the cat combined. One important point to be noticed, so while we have given cat and this some demo file, so while using this we have used for example, I have given some input data. So in order to close this input, I have used Control D. So this Control D option is not only applicable for cat command, but we can use with all the commands which expect for which we are providing some output from the for which we are providing input from keyboard. So when the input is from keyboard, in order to stop the input from keyboard, we can give Control D. So when we press Control D, it will stop the input data stream and it will save that particular command. Now we'll look on to the copying operation, which we perform very frequently in our day-to-day life when we use a computer system. So in Unix, we perform this operation by using a command named cp, small c and small p. So cp with some options, and later on if you see the command usage in the second line on the screen. So cp, there are few options which we can provide, and we can use the without option also the command. Next space source can be the current directory or any other location in the directories or in a complete Unix system path. We can provide any path in the source, and destination can be anything which is existed. Destination is where our source file will be copied. So there are a few set of options that are available. So here on the screen you can view them. For forceful operation, for forceful copy operation, we can use hyphen F option. So when we, for example, when there is a already existing file at the destination with the same name as source, in this case, if we give hyphen F option without any prompt for the user, the copy operation would be successfully by overwriting that particular file. So when using interactive mode, that is I, when we use hyphen I option, so this doesn't happen. So in this case, our script, our command would prompt for the user whether to overwrite or not. And in order to copy directories, so whenever we are copying directories from one directory location, the whole directory to other directory locations or other path, at that time without recursive we cannot perform that operation. So we'll now see on the terminal how to use these options. And the one most important thing is the preserve P. So whenever you are copying a file from one source to the other destination, so at that time all the parameters that are related to the file, like file permissions or a modification time, may not be copied. So at that time using hyphen P option would do that. So it will copy all the access rights which the source has would be copied to the destination, and the modification time too is included in that. Now we log on to the terminal and check all these functionalities. We are now on the terminal. I'm just clearing the screen. So for copy, before copying, we'll just see the files available here. So there are a few files. So I'd like to copy a file named numbers to some destination. So for that, we have to give a command name cp. So source is a file named numbers. I would like to copy it to a folder named desktop. So this operation is successful. So if I want to check whether my file is copied or not, I now need to traverse to the path named desktop. So if I give this, so there are a few files. So our file which is we have copied now, this numbers has been stored here. So again, moving back, and we are checking with the file. Earlier we have copied a file named numbers to the desktop folder. So I'm performing the same operation now using interactive mode. Using hyphen I, if I give this, so copying the same file numbers to the same path. So if I use this, so it is asking me that whether I need to overwrite, because there is already existing file named numbers. So I'll give Y so that I can continue. So now my file has been copied in an interactive mode. So when you don't want to see the prompt and you just want to overwrite the file, particular file at desktop, so we can use hyphen F option in this case. So it would just copy the file by overwriting the existing file. So now I'd like to copy a folder named my directory into a path named desktop. I'd like just to copy to the. So when I do this, my system will throw an error stating that omitting the directory because it's a directory. So in this case, using hyphen R option will solve my problem. That is, I can copy my directory to desktop. So by this, I can do this. So my operation has been done. So if I want to check, I'll just move to desktop and just listing out my directories existing here. So clearing the screen to perform next operations. We can also copy from any location. For example, now I would like to copy from one layer up. So that is from my home directory. So from there, just copying, I'm just moving using double dots. I just move one layer up. So from there, I just want to copy a file named user.lst. And as for the current directory, if I give dot is enough because it would copy to the present working directory. That is my current cursor location. So if I again check now, so my file has been copied, usr.lst has been copied here. So in similar, we can copy from any location to any destination. So whenever you are trying to copy the file in the same path, for example, I have a path named demo, file name called demo, located in my current location, and I would like to copy again it to my present working location. So it if whenever we try in Windows or any operating system, it would throw it all, file already exists. So we can expect the same in this case. So it states that demo and root demo are the same. So in this case, we can copy with demo and we can just rename with some other file, dem. So this copy operation will be successful, and we will be having two files. One is demo and other is dem, which is a duplicate of demo copied file. In order to delete the files, we can use a command named rm space file name. That is, I would like to delete a file name called rm user. So this would delete my file. So if you observe, there won't be any file name user. So rm is used to delete the files. So if I want to delete the complete files here, I'll just give rm star, which would delete the complete entry. So as it's a directory, there is a directory existing in this. We cannot, we have to first delete that directory. Before that, just I'm just clearing the screen. So when we have a files and folders in this manner, so for example, have a file, so ls-l would list the files here. So the earlier operation has deleted the files and it just left with the directory here. So in order to delete the directory, I can just use a command named rf and space rf and start. This would delete everything including directory. For example, before that, I would like to we now execute a command is star. So this would delete everything. So my directory is empty. So in order to check again, we will create a file named 123. That's, so this is a file if you check. And we'll also create a directory called mkdir. Touch one is the directory. We have two files here. So just if I use rm star, so this would delete a file named 123, but it will keep a touch one directory as it is, throwing an error. So if I would like to delete both the operations, then I can use rm-rf, then star. This would do this, would delete both the files and leaving my directory empty. Now moving forward on the move operation. So using mv command, we can move files or directories from one location to the other location in Unix system. So the command usage is like this: so move option, and then we can give source and the destination. So in option we have two, that is one forceful process and the other is the interactive process. Move can also be used to perform rename operations. So we will now log on to the terminal and check how to work with mv command. So clearing the screen before going for move and home directory. Let's see some files here. Okay, so by moving the operation in copy, we keep a copy here and there will be a copy available at the source, but in case of move operation, it will remove from the source directory and it will paste to the destination. For example, we can see a file named ls file on the screen. So I'd like to move that particular file to a path of desktop, on the desktop. In the desktop, ls file. So I'd like to copy it to desktop. So my operation has been successful. If I again list files, you cannot find a file named ls file because it has been now copied onto moved to desktop location. So for that I just go for desktop. So I can also list in this manner as we discussed earlier, desktop, and if I list, it will show all the files that are available in desktop. So ls file is now available. So in reverse, I can also copy the file location from the remote place, that is from desktop. And I would like to copy whichever file you want to copy, or your directory, you will just mention this here. And using dot states that your destination is the current path. So this states that my file is again available, that ls file is available here. So we'll now store back the copied file, ls file we earlier copied, right? So we are again storing back that file to desktop. So now, as discussed, we can also rename the file. I would like, there is a file named ls file one which I would like to rename to ls file. For that, simply we'll just give move file name and the new file name, that is ls file. So this would do the needful. So our file has been now changed from ls file one to ls file. It has been renamed. In the similar, you can change the name of the directories also. We would now check move with interactive process. So if I as we have desktop folder already having, for example, already has a file named ls file. So we'll check, we also have an ls file in the current directories. At the destination directory also we have a file. So if I use mv command with hyphen I and I'm just trying to move this file to the destination which has the same file with the same. So in this case it asks that move whether to overwrite that existing file at the destination. So if I give yes, it will continue the operation. So when we provide n as an input, that will stop the command execution. So no move operation will be happening. By default, move operation is executed in a forceful mode. In order to restrict that, you can use hyphen I option to keep your data safe. Paging output, in the sense whenever we are working with files with larger amount of data and we want to see the content in the data, so at that time the content of the data is displayed on the screen in the form of pages. That is we can go through the content one by one in the form of pages, where the each page is of our screen size. So earlier the original pager for Unix system is PG. PG has a very limited amount of features. So We have an another option called more. This is also used for paging the output. More is available with almost all the implementations of Unix and Unix-like systems, and more is very simple to use and very user friendly. So we'll now log on to the terminal and we'll check how to use more and pg. We are now on the terminal. I'm just clearing out the previous output. So if I would like to see, I would like to see a long list, and I would like to see the files available on my system. So there are a few files. So if you want to use pg for paging the output, so we can use pg space that file name named ps list. So when you give this, it will open the screen. So so if you want to go some particular line, so if you give 100, so it will take us to the particular line. So if you want to search for a particular pattern name, for example, I would like to search for a username Nanu. So giving a forward slash and that username would take us to the pattern of few user in this paging. So now I would like to quit using up this. So we will now look into more. Paging has a very limited number of options. So we are using more here. So when we use more, it's very user friendly. If you observe on the screen, so now I'm opening PS underscore list. PS list file using more. So whenever I want to move forward, so by pressing F on your keyboard will take you one page higher. So you can also see the percentage where 1% has been increased. So in order to go down by down the page, we can also use spacebar in order to move forward. So if you want to repeat the same command again, we can use dot. So dot would do the same as F, as we have earlier used F command, or we have used space. So dot would be the repetition of the previous command. So whenever I want to go backward one way, so using B would do that. B will take me one step backward. So whenever you give a colon F on the screen, so it would display the file name and the line network we are present. Whenever you open multiple files using this more command, at that time colon N would take you to the next file and colon P would take you to the previous file. So here we, as we have opened only a single file, we cannot use that option. So error will be prompted as there is no other file rather than this current file. So if I want to move to some particular pattern, or if I want to search for some particular pattern, then giving forward slash and that will take me to that particular pattern. So we, as we have searched for Anup, Anup has been shown on the screen. So the lines containing Anup has been shown. The first hit will be gone. So whenever you press N, our search will be continued in a forward direction. That means our last search will be repeated. So when you are working on the pure Unix system or the Unix-like systems, there are few commands which only works on Unix systems, that is J and K. When you use J, it will take line by line forward, and when you use K, it will take line by line backward. So these commands can be executed only on Unix systems. These are not executable on Linux. So we can also move to the particular line number by using 200 and capital G. So this will take me to the 200th line in that particular file. So by using capital G, it will take us to the last line of the file in Unix. Use Q to, in order to quit the file. So by using typing Q, small q, it will quit the more command, and now we are on to the terminal back. So we'll now see how to split larger files. So when you have a large file, and if you want to break that file into equal sized files or equal number of line sized files, so at that time split command comes for the rescue. So using split command, we can split the file into a particular file number. This, for example, I have a file of 250 lines. So what by default does split command would do is, whenever I give a split that particular file name which is having 2050 lines, so it will split that file into three files. Whenever you are given a split command with no option, then the file will be splitted with 1000 lines in each file. It will create two files, and the third file will be created with 50 lines, as 2050 can be broken into three pieces according to the logic. So whenever you want to have your particular broken files with a particular file lines, that is particular number of file lines, we can mention that in the split in the option space. If I want to have 100 lines in each file, then I can make split space hyphen 100, then file name. It would split the files in 100 lines each. So we'll now log on to the terminal and check this. So we are now on the terminal. So we are now on the terminal. We have a file named pslist. So we are going to just split that particular file. So split. For now, I'm just giving with no option. So split pslist. As a command executed, we can see now that the splits has been created. So when you see at the right hand side of the screen, the top, there we can see a few files created like XAA and XBB and in continuation XAC and XCD. So these files will be created in this with these naming conventions. The split files will be created whenever we click on to the file. So ls-l will give the long listing of the file. So if you see that XAA, when you see for this, we can check the lines of the file that particular file has using WCC. So if you use this command, you can see that XAA has 1000. So when you check, XAB will have 1000. So by default, a split will split the larger file into smaller files of 1000 lines each. So we can mention with another option called split space. So the number of lines you want to include, so that we can see here. So XD. So the last file which is created will have a lesser number of lines. So if you see, the rest of the lines will be stored in this file. So this is how we can split a larger amount of data into small chunks of data. Now we'll see split command with the option. Before splitting further, I'm just removing the older file using X and star. So all the files will of starting with X will be now deleted. So we are in back to the state that we have been in. I would now split the file called pslist with a 2000 lines each. So for that I'll give 2000, and now I'll give pslist. So this would split my file. So when you observe, there are only three files now available: XAA, XAB, and XAC. So I'll just count the number of lines in each file. So XAA will have 2000, XB will have 2000. So now the third one will have the rest of the files which are available. So when you see, it has only 1600 lines, so which are remaining after splitting into two files. Earlier we have split the file names because we already, we have removed the files because we already have a files name called XAA. So we can also create our user defined names. So now I would like to split the files which we have got from the earlier split operation, that is XAA. So I would now like to split the file with 500 lines each, for example, 500 lines each. Now I would like to split XAA. So we can give a predefined name. So I would like to have, instead of X, I would like to have chunks. So this will be executed. So whenever I list the file, so when you can see that the chunks AA, chunks ABB has been present. So when you want to check, so if it checks chunks AA, so it will show that each and every, so my file has been now divided with 500 lines each. So this is how we can work with the splitting operation. We will now check how to perform the file comparisons. We can perform three types of operations in comparison. One is comparing both the files and finding the differences. So we have, by using cmp command, which we can compare two files, and by using com, that is COMM, common command, we can get to know the common things which the file has. So we see how those will be listed on the screen. Now by using diff command, we can find the differences between the two files. So now we log on to the terminal and check these operations. So here we have two files named cars, which includes a luxury brands like Toyota, Audi, Bentley, Benz, BMW, and Range Rover. And we have another sector of economical cars, which also produces economical cars, that is Toyota, Suzuki, and Hyundai. So we are now comparing these two files. So whenever you compare two files, the first encountered difference would be listed out here. So I would like to compare the cars and eco cars. When you perform this, So the first encountered one is the byte 8 and line number 2. When you observe the inputs of both the things, you see that in first line we have Toyota and Toyota in both the files, but whenever we coming to the second one, so in Echo cars we don't have a entry named Audi, we have some other entry. So the second file differs at some particular location at line number 2. So this gives the first occurrence of the difference. So whenever you compare the similar files, for example, I would like to compare cars with cars again. So in this case, as there are no differences, there won't be any output. We'll just get the prompt back. So in this case, we got the prompt back because there won't be any difference between when we compare the same file with the other, which is similar to it. So we'll now see working with common. The com command, the COMM command, in order to find the common between two files, the two files needed to be sorted. If we don't provide a sorted list, our command throws an error that both the files need to be sorted. So when we execute, so for now these two files doesn't have a sorted data. So we'll now see what it throws. So then we can see that file 2 is not in a sorted order. For that we would first sort the file and we'll again execute this command. So we are now sorting both the files. So for sort we use sort. Now we are first to sorting on echo cars file, and we are now storing on the file named echo c. So and we are now sorting again back the cars file, and we will now store it to file named ca. So for now we'll just see the sorted data on both the files. So echo c has sorted data, and we will see on ca2. So both the files now has an sorted data. So now if you compare the com, and now if you want to list the files here, so I'm just giving ca, which is a file having luxury cars, and next my echo c file, which is having another set of numbers. So when you see your output will be shown in three different fields. The first one states that throws the content which is very specific to that particular file. So Audi, Bentley, Benz, BMW, whichever the items existed here are only belongs to CA, and this doesn't belong to EcoC. So it is thrown here. So when you go for the second field, these two entries, Hyundai and Suzuki, are only present in EcoC but not present in file one, so they have been listed in the file in the second field. So the third field would consist the common entry between the two files. So this would have, so when you want to look only the common things between the two parameters, then we need to eliminate the field one and field two. For that we just give com space hyphen. So we need to eliminate field one and field two, which contains the unique parameters to those respective files. So we use hyphen 1 and 2, which will eliminate the data from them, and we'll now give the comparison. So echo c, so it will now display the common between two files. So as Toyota is the common between them, we have seen that in the output. So if you want to see the unique things between the two files, so we'll just eliminate the field number 3 here. This will display the contents which are unique to file 1 and file 2 in field 1 and field 2 respectively. So if you see that field 1 consists of contents which are unique, so the common things between two files are now eliminated using com hyphen 3. So we can use 1, 2 and 3. So here 1, 2 and 3 states for the field 1, field 2 and field 3. So whenever you are just interested in checking whether both the files are similar or not, just we can use combine command, and using with no argument we'll give list out the differences. So when there are some differences, we can simply straight away state that these both files are not similar. So if you are, your intention is just to check whether the both the files are similar or not, compared with no argument is enough. We would now look about the difference. So using the difference, we can find the difference between two files. So when I would like to say between these, so echo c are the two files in which we are using. So when you observe the output from the command, it states that in the first line, when you see the, so it states that 1,5 c1 and comma 2. So that states that in the first file, fifth line, So fifth line character one has a difference when compared with the second file, so that we have a difference of Toyota, which that it states that we have a common one Toyota in both the files at line five in first file. So in order to change this particular file, we need to change. So unlike comparison or common, in difference also states that which lines has to be changed in order to make the two files identical. Here all the differences in both the files will be stated. So whenever you want to make two files identical, so using difference command, we can get to know that at which lines we have to make the changes so as to make two files identical. Thank you for watching the video. Stay tuned for more information.